Hey y'all, welcome or welcome back. My name is Saskia and this is Saskia Digital Budgeting. In today's video, we are going to be budgeting and stuffing paycheck number 2 of July. So if that sounds like something you're interested in, go ahead and stay tuned. All right, so we are budgeting and stuffing paycheck number 2 of July. Let's go ahead and get on into it. So my paycheck this week was $2,002.71. I just rounded up to 2003. This is the first paycheck where I'm back on night shift, so I am getting that lovely night shift differential. So my paychecks will basically be looking like that, if not better, for, you know, the foreseeable future. Yay! Except for when I take vacation. I'm not looking forward to that. So let's go ahead and count this money. It should be $2,003. It's a lot. All right, I'm not dealing with all this nonsense. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20, 40, 60, 80, 1,000, 20, 40, 60, 81, 20, 40, 60, 82, 20, 40, 60, 83, 20, 40, 60, 84, 20, 40, 60, 85, 20, 40, 60, 86, 20, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 97, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 98. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 99, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 85, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, 100, 1, 2, 3. So we have the $2,000 that we are supposed to have, 2003, more specifically. So how has y'all's week been? We're at the end of the month. It's, you know, just creeping on past, as it always does. Shocks the heck out of me. I just have no concept of time, I guess. I don't know. The days fly by. I guess that's just what that is. Alrighty. Oop, that is just hideous. Okay. Can we cooperate? Alright, so let's go ahead and jump right on in to our bills. So, this is the last, the last sad paycheck where I am pulling less than $500 out of the paychecks for rent, because I think next paycheck it goes up to like 700 and something. Not excited, but you know, adulting is adulting, but that's fine because my paychecks will be going up to make up for that, so that's fine. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 450 is going in here. Deep. And then utilities is hanging out still at $70. 40, 60, 70. Rightio. All right. And then we've got internet, which is getting $25. I had to increase this. I'm probably gonna have to increase it again here in the near future because I apparently no longer qualify for the student discount. Don't know what that's about, but yeah. There was a student discount that for internet, which gave me like $30 off, because I'm a student and I need internet. And yeah, for whatever reason, I don't qualify anymore, or at least so says the system, but I still need to call and verify that and see if there's somebody on their end that can do something about that, because I'm not interested in paying full price for internet when I'm still a student and I should still qualify, but you know, who knows? Maybe it's because I'm in my 30s. I don't know. Power here is getting $30 as usual. Vet bills next is getting $31. Ooh. Blech. All right. And then maybe cat stuff is getting $15. I need to pay some of these bills actually, but I was waiting for this paycheck because it came at the very end of the month, so bills need to be paid. It's always like the weird thing about getting that third paycheck. It like offsets your normal bill schedule, because like if one paycheck comes in the middle of the month, the other paycheck comes at like the end of the month, and it takes a little bit for it to like reset itself. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just complaining for the sake of complaining. It's not really that big of an inconvenience, but that is what that is. All right, bills paid. Yay. Ugh, gosh. Alrighty, now we're gonna move right on down to our spending allowances here. Alright, so let's find out what is left over from last paycheck, and I'm just gonna go ahead and tell you it's definitely a lot more than normal because I didn't do anything. I didn't go anywhere. I didn't do any of the things. So gas has $8 left over. Food, I don't know. Actually, I know exactly how I managed this. I started seeing somebody and we've gone out to, you know, eat, and he is stubbornly not allowing me to pay for anything. So not spending money on food and stuff like that. I didn't have to buy as many groceries, and yeah, so I have $81 left over in food. Coffee is empty and spent. General has 25 left over in it, and then laundry, I didn't need to do laundry this week, or I didn't need to refill my laundry app thingamajig, so I still have $10 left in it. All right, so this, we've got 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 110, 115, 120, 121, 122, 23, and 124 left over from my spending allowances out of 290. That's, I mean, it's not terrible. It's really the food that made the biggest difference because I wasn't spending money. But after I'm done recording all of this, I need to go grocery shopping. So next paycheck, this paycheck, the money that's going in here right now, it will not look the same likely. All right, so as usual, gas is getting $50. And I don't know why, but gas like dropped like 20 cents and then went up like 30 cents like 4 days later. I don't know what that's about, but I'm not happy about it. But I don't have to buy gas probably for another like week or week and a half maybe. So maybe it'll change in the time between now and then. Coffee is getting 50 as usual. And then general spending is gonna get 60 if I can get this guy open. And then laundry, last up, is getting its usual $10 here. All right, so that is that. And now we're back to the envelope at the back here, which is all of my receipts from this pay period. Actually, I'm not even sure if it's all from this pay period. It might be some from last, but either way, I need to scan these on in to my Fetch app. And if you don't know what Fetch is, I will leave my referral code up here on the screen. Fetch is basically an app where you scan in your receipts or you upload them from Amazon or from your email, and you get points for those receipts. And if you buy certain things, you get extra points. And those points turn into gift cards that you can redeem for, you know, or redeem for gift cards, like for restaurants, for shopping, for clothing, you know, all of the things, entertainment kind of type stuff. And it is nice. It's free money basically just for scanning your receipts. So go ahead and do that. Use my referral code. You get some bonus points when you use my referral code and scan your first receipt, and then I get a couple of extra bonus points for referring you. So it works out, right? Okay, so that being that, let's head on over to, if I can, hello, to our sinking funds here. Starting on up with my emergency fund binder. Yay. All right, so main savings is getting $200, which is 10% of my paycheck as per usual. I always put 2% or 10%, excuse me, 10% of my paycheck in main savings every pay period, because that's just good savings. So we've got in here 1,000, 2,000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 600, 620, 640, 660, 680. Is that right? Can I not count? Yeah, 680, 85, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95. So 695. Why do I feel like that is so weird? It is 695. To the, hello? 2,695. I don't know why my tablet there freaked out for a second, but whatever. All right, up next here is auto. Auto is just getting a nice $10 today. So it looks like we have $220 in here. Can we stop freaking out, please? And then onto our emergency fund, which is getting $30 today. I tried to put a little bit more in some of the categories since I had a little bit more money, but also at the same time, I wanted to put a lot of money into savings challenges, but, you know, it didn't really work out as well as I had hoped. So $30 went into emergency fund. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 500, 20, 40, 60, 80, 600, 620, 630, 640, 650 in emergency fund. Nice. And for emergency fund, I have a goal of $1,000 by the end of the year. That's definitely achievable. All right, new car is getting $40. So in new car, I have 5,000, 6,000, 7,000, 8,000, 9,000, 1, 2, 300, 320, 340, 360, 380, 400. So 9,400 is nice. It's very nice. 9,400. Still, I know I keep saying this every like paycheck, but I still plan on looking at getting a new car here in the next two and a half months. So that is good. That is a nice little down payment. Home is getting $20. So in home, we have 1,000, 100, 2, 3, 4, 400, 420, 440, 460, 480, 510. 1,000, $510. All right, that's not too bad. All right, on to my high priority sinking funds. Starting out here with school, which is basically empty, and we need to start replenishing, yay. So, in school, adding $30 in afterwards, we have 20, 40, 60, 81, 20, 40, 60, 70, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84. So 184, which is not bad considering I spent like $1,000 of it a month ago. Month ahead is getting $40. This is one of the ones that I like added a little bit extra to because I had the money, and we have 100, 20, 40, 60, 80, 90, 205. In here, honestly, this goal is something close to like $2,000 just for a single month because everything is expensive. Vacation is getting $20. Some of this money is going to disappear in the next month because I am taking a 3-day trip out of state with the guy I'm seeing, and then I have my birthday vacation at the end of September. So this money will probably, some of it will go, but it's nice to actually take vacation, so I'm not complaining. So we have 1,000, 2,000, 1, 2, 3, 4, 500, 540. So 2,540, very nice. All right, and then in me and mine, I'm giving myself $40 because yes. And my envelope is wonky donky. I don't know why. Okay, so 40 into me and mine. So we have 1, 200, 20, 40, 60, 70, 80, 280, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 289. Okay, not too shabby. New tech is getting $10. New tech has 100, 20, 40, 60, 80, 90, 200, 210, 211, 212, 213. And yes, this is an envelope that I'm still debating on whether or not I'm actually going to get rid of it or not. So we'll see. Social here is going to get $10. Yeah, that's right. So in social, we have 20, 40, 60, 70, 80. Haven't really, like, I've gone and done stuff, but I haven't actually had to spend any money. I don't know how that works. I'm not gonna complain though. But yeah, so social is just building up for a nice little blowout or something. Who knows? Pantry stock up here in my lower priority sinking funds is getting $20. So we have $80 in here as well. And then home goods here next is getting $15 today. So we have $20, $30, $40, $50, $55, $60. and Home Goods. Medical is going to get $10. So we have $20, $40, $50, $60, $70, $75 in medical, which is mildly surprising. Because, like, I've been putting basically nothing in medical all year. Gifts is going to get $15. I still have to figure out what I'm getting for my friend's baby shower and then for my cousin's wedding. So, yeah, that, who knows. My cousin's wedding isn't until November, but my friend's baby shower is at, like, towards the end of September. So I still have, like, another month and a half to get this situated. So we have $20, $40, $60, $70, $80, $90, $95, $100 in gifts. That is good. And then a budgeting in YouTube is getting $15. So we've got $20, $30, $40, $45, and $50 here in budgeting in YouTube. And then yearly subscriptions is going to get $25. So we've got $100, $20, $40, $60, $80, $80, $90, $95, $200 in yearly subscriptions. That's actually pretty good. Alrighty, so that is it for our sinking funds. Nothing is going towards debt, and we can just go ahead and play in the savings challenges, y'all. Alright, so first up here is going to be, we're going to flip to our payday savings challenge. I got paid on the 27th, so we are putting $27 in here today. $6 and $27. If I can organize all the money. Ooh, there you go. All right. Payday challenge taken care of. And then let's go ahead and deal with our spending allowance leftover. We had $124 to play with. So let's figure out what we can do. Let's go with the biggest. Next biggest one is 94. I need a calculator. Hold on, please. All right. So, 94. So, 124. I don't know if y'all can even see that. 124. Minus 94, which is the next one, is 30. 30 is already colored, but I can do 29 and 1, so we're going to do that. So 94, 29, and 1. We like coloring off 3 at the same time. That's nice, yeah? And then I'll get this all organized. This envelope always needs a condensing, just always. Always needs condensing. Because this envelope is not a fan of all of, you know, the 15, 20 ones right there. But that's fine, because that's coming up next week. So, it's a nice little segue, right? I want to see this farther along, but I know it'll happen, so I'm not going to, like, freak out about it. But, oof. Get in there. There we go. There we go. Alrighty. That guy's going in. All right, so the last thing on the agenda is to put away the savings challenge money for the savings challenge stuffing for August from this paycheck. So let's, it should be 343, so let's find out. So we have 100, 20, 40, 60, 82, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 93, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 41, 42, 43. Yep, so 343, this is going towards the savings challenge stuffing for August, plus the first whatever I put in from the first paycheck of August. So it'll be 2 paychecks worth. Look at that. It's all pretty. I like it. Okay, that's it. Alrighty. So that is all I've got for you today. We did all of the things. We did the sinking funds. We did the bills. We did the saving allowances, all the fun things, our spending allowances, and all of that. So I will leave you guys here. I hope you guys had a wonderful week. And going into the weekend, go ahead and do something nice for yourself. Nothing Nothing too stressful. Try and relax if you can. I know life gets in the way of that sometimes, but do what you can to rest and recharge, whether that's spending alone time, spending time with friends, family, spouse, whatever it is, that does it for you, okay? And I will catch you guys next week for the end of month update and bill condensing for July. So I'll see you then.
Peace.